Hey guys, Welsknight here, bringing you another brand new episode in my Minecraft 1.8 single player survival series. And in this episode, we are going to be building ourselves an armory to store all of the equipment like armor and weapons and whatnot that we have picked up. It's getting kind of cluttered upstairs in my basement. So, down here, I'll show you where this is. Basically, you just take the ladder from my basement down to where the minecart track is, and to where my underground farms are down there. And then I went right in here and I hollowed out a room. This room is 15 by 10. I did leave these corners in, and you'll see why in a minute. So the first thing I want to do is make this room all pretty with these stone brick walls. So we're going to use this pickaxe. This is a silk touch pickaxe, which is pretty awesome. I don't know why I hollowed out that corner. That was kind of silly of me, because these walls right here are just meant to be the walls. Nothing fancy whatsoever. So we'll put those in, and then the same thing's going to happen over here, just like this. And I should have enough stone brick that I can do this. The silk touch pickaxe definitely helps when obtaining stone brick, because you don't actually have to smelt down your cobblestone. You can just turn it right into the stone bricks, which is really nice. Now we're going to get rid of this diorite in the ceiling. And the ceiling I'm just going to leave as plain old boring smooth stone. You might change that later and throw some glowstone lighting in here or something like that. I think we're also just going to leave the floor as plain old glowstone as well. So, the next thing that we're going to want to do is put up some torches and get this room all lit up. Now, this is the middle. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to put a torch there and a torch here. And then we'll put a torch here and a torch here. And the reason behind the positioning of these torches will be totally sensical in a moment. It'll totally make sense once I get the chests and everything else that I'm going to put down here in place. So then let's see. Here we're going to go and put a torch here, a torch here, and we'll just leave that one, I think. And we'll do the same thing over here. Where's that one at? Right here. Okay. So that's good for now. Now we're going to go ahead and take these resources that we've gathered upstairs, throw them in a chest. I'm just going to throw them in a random chest because we don't need them anymore. We will still need a little bit of smooth stone. Now we're going to come over here and grab some other stuff. We're going to need some chests. That's not going to be enough of them though, so we'll definitely need some more. Let's see, we're going to need a pretty good amount of wood for this, specifically for sticks. And actually, now that I think about it, we're going to need a pretty good amount of wood for other stuff too. Let's see, do I have any more wood lying around in any of these chests? Not so much. Okay. Well, you know what? That's okay. I think we'll be okay with the amount that we've got. So now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to come to a crafting table, and we're going to turn all of these into stone slabs. We are going to make a whole bunch of sticks. And these sticks are going to go like that. And those stone slabs are going to go right there to give us a whole bunch of armor stands, because those are always nice to have. I think that will be enough. Now we'll turn all these into chests. And I don't know if that's going to be enough, but I have another crafting table with me if I need to make more down there. So, okay, now we head back into the armory, and we're going to grab our armor stands. We're going to put an armor stand here, a chest there, an armor stand here, a chest there, and these armor stands can actually be angled like that, so that's what we're going to do. Just like that. And we'll do the same thing over here. I am definitely going to need some more chests, but it looks like I'll have enough armor stands. And I won't need a whole lot more chests. It looks like I'll only need one. So we'll just go ahead and throw down that. And we'll make ourselves one big chest or two smaller chests until you combine them like that. Okay, so there's that part. Now we've got that all nice and laid out. Next, we'll head back up here. And this stuff can pretty much all go back. Actually, I might need some of this again. Because next up, we are going to label our chests. Looks like I am going to need some more leather as well. Now, I did pick up a very nice sword for this purpose, for gathering leather. It's got the looting 2 enchantment on it, which isn't the best looting enchantment, but it will definitely increase the rate at which we are able to gather leather from our ranch outside. So we're going to run out there real quick and get ourselves some leather. We're going to use that leather to make item frames so that we can label all of those chests and keep everything nice and organized. And looks like we've got witches burning over there. That's all right. As you can see off camera, I've definitely been doing some breeding of cows and whatnot. So we're going to pick up some of these nice drops. And let's just keep an eye on how much leather we got. I think I'll stop once I've got about 30 leather. That's going to be more than I need, but this herd can afford to be thinned a little bit. It's not the end of the world. And with the looting enchantment, it shouldn't take a whole lot of time to get us to that point. So, let's see. We're at 27, 28, 29, and we'll just finish that one off. And I think that should be plenty. Let's go ahead and head back to the house. And we'll just come through the door. I'm apparently struggling to walk through the door. And we'll come on down here. And now we're going to make ourselves some item frames. I should have everything I need there, so we're good. We're going to deposit some of this stuff. And we're going to start grabbing some of this stuff. Because, you know, I need the space. And we'll come on down here, head into our armory. And let's start decorating some of these armor stands a little bit. I think we'll put that there. We'll put that there. Over on this side, we'll do some leather armor. And then maybe a set of iron armor or something. I don't know. Doesn't really matter. What'd I do with that crafting table? Here we go. Now we're going to make ourselves some item frames. We'll start with 8. But we are going to need more than that. So let's make... let's just go ahead and make another 8. Item frames are always a good thing to have around. We're going to put these item frames just like this. Oh, I messed that up, didn't I? Yes, I did. That's all right. We want that torch right there. And that item frame to go there, and that item frame to go there. There we go. So now we've got that all nice and laid out. Now, let's start on this side and do horse armor here. And we'll put all our nice horse armor that we've collected right there. We'll do saddles in this chest. I think we'll do bows in this chest. And I think that's pretty much everything we need for down here. So now we can just run up and down, gather all of our gear, and get it put away and nice and organized for us. So we'll put some of this stuff away. Let's see. I want that armory to be only for gear related to combat, like armor, swords, arrows will go down there. Looks like I don't have any more bows. Oh, yes, I do. I have one bow. And I do have this sword. So we'll just swap that out for this shovel at the moment, just temporarily. Yeah, oh, there's another sword. Alright, we'll put some sticks in there. And there's another sword. Oh man, I've got so much stuff, guys. This is why I needed to get organized right here, so I can find the things that I need quickly and easily. Because when you have a lot of stuff, it can really become a pain to figure out what's supposed to go where. We're going to put diamond swords in here. We're going to put iron swords in here. We're going to... my microphone there. Hopefully that didn't totally just mess up my sound for the rest of the video. That would be really unfortunate. But let's go ahead and put our bow in there. Let's see. We still have some more saddles, so we'll put those in there. This horse armor we'll put there. Let's go ahead and decorate that. I think this one is going to be an iron one as well. And we'll make this the chest for stone swords. Oh, and I'm still missing one more horse armor. There we go. There, now that looks all nice and organized. We can add more to this as we go, like gold armor, steel armor, etc. Or iron armor, I should say, etc., etc., etc. So we can expand on this and make it prettier and more organized as we go along. And as we gather more stuff, that'll help us when we're up here trying to figure out where we're going to put various things. So let's put these sticks and this coal back in our inventory. And now we're going to head down to the mine, I think, for a little bit. So let's just swing down here. And I've got some awesome, awesome news related to the channel. I have decided, as some of you know, it was my birthday on Monday, the 27th. I got an Amazon gift card, among some other things, for my birthday. And I decided that it was time to get myself a good, or at least decent, microphone. So I ordered it tonight. I've got a CAD U37 studio condenser mic coming in the mail. It should be here Tuesday, and I can promise you, you will definitely notice a difference in the quality of the audio in all of my videos after I get that microphone. Right now, I am recording using a very inexpensive, cheap little, like a $10 desktop microphone. It's jimmy-rigged with a stand, basically... Basically, it is zip-tied onto a guitar stand right now, and it's really kind of a nightmare. So the studio mic will definitely make a lot of difference when it comes to the audio quality. So that is good news for sure. I'm also going to be starting out a few new things after I get that microphone that I have been wanting to do, but I've been waiting on because of... the lack of proper equipment. So you will see probably within the next several months, you'll probably see, where is my shovel? My shovel has disappeared. This is unfortunate. I seem to have left my shovel in the equipment box. Oh, woe is me. Woe is me. That's alright. You know what? I'm going to show you a trick for mining gravel. So gravel can be a very annoying thing because it likes to fall on top of each on itself. So what we're going to do is you break it and you put a torch down. And when it falls, it's supposed to break all of the other gravel above it. Just like that. There we go. That first time I think I put the torch in too fast. There we go. So you do it just like that, and it can really help when you're trying to break up all that gravel that gets gathered on the side. Anyway, so as I was saying, new microphone coming. Very excited about that. The bad news is I have military stuff going on this weekend. I'm going to be out of town from Friday afternoon until very late Sunday night, probably. So once this video goes up, you may not see another video from me until probably Monday would be my guess. I might be able to work it where I can upload from, you know, like I leave and I set it to upload while I'm gone, but odds are there's probably going to be a couple days where you don't see a new video from me because I'm off doing military stuff. And unfortunately, you can't really tell the Army, you know, hey guys, I'm not going to be able to come to training because I've got a YouTube channel and, like, my fans need me. So if you could just, like, excuse me from my military duties, that would be great. Yeah, it doesn't work that way. So, short of catching Ebola, I will have to be at my drill. I will have to be doing boring things, sitting around, twiddling my thumbs, and pretending to look busy. And, yeah, I will be back Monday, though. So, I think that is pretty much it for channel news. And I think I've got two little mines out here. As you can see, this mine has expanded pretty enormously since the last time we were down here. But I wanted to share that exciting news with you. So I am going to go ahead and end the episode right here, guys. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to like, subscribe, or leave me a comment. I really appreciate it, and it helps keep me motivated. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.